Hey y'all, welcome to Kamara's Kitchen. Today we're making a citrus glazed salmon, mashed sweet potatoes, and roasted asparagus. I'm bringing you all an easy, quick, and healthy recipe, and it all starts with washing some sweet potatoes. Now, I've already cleaned these, but guys, look at the size of these. This is the smallest sweet potato I have ever gotten from the store, but they all came in the bag like that, but I thought that was so funny. Anyway, I'm gonna cover these up with olive oil. And I'm gonna roast this at 425 degrees until they are soft. So that's gonna take about 35 minutes for these ones because they're small, but you know, as long as it takes for yours, okay? Now, in a casserole dish, I'm gonna add a little bit of olive oil and we're gonna start working on that salmon. Okay, honey, now I've already taken this salmon and I have cut it into about 4 to 6 ounce pieces. Try to cut them evenly so they will cook evenly. Now, I'm gonna rub these salmons down with some fresh minced garlic. Yes, you got to mince it yourself to get that flavor, okay. Now I'm gonna take a little ginger. Now this ginger is frozen, so it'll grate easy, and I'm going to just grate a little bit over the top. No measurements, y'all. This is no measurement seasoning like your mamas and your grandmamas did it. Just put it over there to the right, okay. So just put a little over there. Now, this is my citrus. I'm using an orange and I did wash it very well because that wax is on there. And I'm just going to turn my microplane and zest this orange. Now, when you're zesting, you wanna make sure that you don't go over the white pithy part because that part is bitter. And you do wanna get the zest from the bottom of that microplane. Now I'm gonna go in with a little Old Bay because y'all know seafood and Old Bay just blend together real well, honey. You know, but be careful with it. It do got a little salt, okay? So I'm gonna put a little bit out on there and then I'm gonna just go in with a little pinch of salt, not much at all, and just a tad bit of honey. This is not supposed to be super sweet. And I'm actually just going to make one quick little line down the middle of each piece of salmon, and you don't even really need to rub it in because the honey's gonna melt in the oven and it'll just spread itself out. All right, now to keep everything moist, I'm going to put some butter on the top, and I'm using a salted grass-fed butter today. I think it tastes a lot better. It's a lot richer than your typical butter, especially if you're using it to baste. And I'm just gonna put little pieces on there. And then I'm gonna squeeze on some lemon. I'm using my fingers so that I can catch all of the seeds that come out so that doesn't bake with my salmon. Now I'm gonna put this aside and then I'm gonna start working on this asparagus. Now you guys have seen me do asparagus a few times and you all know that it starts with chopping off that woody part. But I did wanna give you a couple tips. One, you wanna pick some asparagus that's about the size of a pencil. I think the smaller ones are a little bit more tender, so I like to go for that size. I'm also going to be seasoning this one a little differently than you've seen me do in the past. I'm going to be seasoning this, of course, with some olive oil first to get everything to stick, but I'm gonna be using some Herbes de Provence. Okay, y'all, I'm fancy, I'm speaking a little French, okay. Well, this seasoning has lavender in it and it gives it a really nice floral taste, which is very unique and I quite enjoyed it. Now, here's our herbs here, and it has other ones in it too, like a little rosemary, I think, thyme, marjoram, all types of stuff. And I'm using about a teaspoon. Now, y'all guys also saw me put on some of that fresh garlic, as y'all know that I put on my asparagus. I do it every time, and I'm just using about a teaspoon of these herbs. If you think lavender sounds a little weird on asparagus, you know what? It's not. It was very good. Now, this is some garlic pepper seasoning. I make this blend, but they have pre-made garlic pepper seasoning blends in the store. But if you wanna see and you wanna know how I make mine, just let me know in the comments. I actually make a lot of my own seasoning blends, and I'd be happy to share them with you. Now, I am going to roast this salmon for about 10 minutes at 425 degrees, and I'm gonna do the asparagus for about 13 minutes. You do it as long as it takes for yours to get brown, soft, and crispy. While these are in the oven, my sweet potatoes are ready, okay? You can see they're oozing out. They're nice and roasted and sweet. You can boil them, but I don't recommend that because you're not gonna get the same flavor out of them. Now, these babies are piping hot, okay? They are piping hot, honey. And I need to separate them from the skins. So I just use a spoon and a knife to carefully scoop out all the meat. All right, now something that you have to address when you're making a sweet potato mash is those strings. And you can see me kind of pulling them up to the camera. Guys, those strings got to go, okay? Now, I'm sure you've seen some recipes where they just take the sweet potatoes and just mash them all together, and you certainly can do that, but I just feel like the strings are a no. So to address that, I'm gonna put this in my food processor. Add all of your hot sweet potato mash, and I'm gonna use some coconut milk to blend it. I'm gonna use just the top cream. Okay, I didn't shake this up, as you can see, and I'm putting in about 3 tablespoons. You do as much as you like. I'm putting in about 1 tablespoon of salted butter. I'm also gonna be adding about 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract, as well as about 1/4 teaspoon of rum. If you have rum in your house, then use the real rum, but I don't typically have it. I'm gonna put in about 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon and just a few pinches of some nutmeg. Now, of course, you want to taste this to make sure this is the right, you know, the right flavoring for you. I'm just gonna put in about 1 teaspoon of honey. That is totally optional. If you have some super sweet potatoes, it's not even needed. And you're gonna find that you're gonna just blend out all of those strings. Do you see that? So smooth, so delightful, very good alternative to mashed potatoes and full of fiber. Guys, I'm just gonna plate this for you. I'm gonna put on my sweet potatoes that are sweet and roasted and delicious, my herbal asparagus, and my beautiful citrus salmon. Guys, I love this recipe, and I hope you do too. Remember that I love you, and God loves you too. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.